any questions.
Chief, it's probably too early, but have you been able to identify any of those pictures, or any of those pictures involving Fresno Unified students?
We have not been able to identify who the individuals are, the children, on the computers, as well as have not been able to identify any of the adults that have been engaged in sexual acts with these kids. But that will be part of our investigation. We are hopeful that these photographs, we will be able to determine who they are, the children as well as the adults, so that we can further that investigation. But at this point, it's premature.
Do you believe that he took these photographs himself or was merely collecting them? And do you believe that any of the children that he had contact with, either at school or in any other facets of his life, were victims of it?
We are not certain whether or not these were simply shared images or images that were downloaded from the internet or photographs that Mr. Zane took himself. That is still part of our ongoing investigation. And we do not know at this point in time whether the photographs that are on this computer are actually of any students from the Fresno County area. And so we are looking at all of that, and hopefully over the next couple of weeks we'll be able to determine more information regarding that.
Does he show up on any of these images, the suspect himself?
At this point, we've not been able to see actually all of the photographs. We've been able to view about 1,000 of the photos, but there hasn't been any enhancements done or any detailed analysis to look to see if, in fact, he is part of these photographs. At this point, there is no indication that he is, but that may change.
Are these boys and girls?
These are both male and female children that are engaged in sexual acts, but it's my understanding that the majority of the photographs and where sexual acts were occurring were of females.
Does he have any family members? Like children or anything else?
Yeah, Mr. Zane is currently married. His wife has been interviewed as part of this investigation. And he also has adult children and grandchildren.
And how old is he?
He is 57 years old.
Is his wife also with Fresno Unified by any chance?
At this point, we've been working primarily with the suspect's work-related files. I don't even know her full name and proper name and whether there's a different name involved. It'll be something we're working on, but we are simply at our first here in support of the chief. So we couldn't answer that for you yet.
Superintendent Henson, have you talked to the staff and teachers at the two schools are involved, and what have you told them?
We have not. I have not spoken with the staffs at those schools directly yet. As you heard, this arrest is very recent, and John Marinovich, our chief academic officer, has spoken with the principals, and we're putting our plans in place. Our school year begins with students coming back on August 18th. Staff will be joining us right before that, so we're right in the midst of getting our communications out and briefing our staffs as to what's going on.
Mr. Henson, you said he started as a substitute teacher way back in 1991.
Yes, 1991 is what our records show, and then he became, I believe that was the first year in our district, 90, 91, 91, 92 as substitutes, but then he moved into the tenure track position, a full-time position in 92, I believe.
Okay.
Are those the only schools where he taught?
No, he, with the music program. We are actually combing through all of our records right now. As you can imagine, we are going through a major upgrade in our human resources software system, but currently what we have is paper and pencil kind of records. And so we're going through and combing every one of those to make sure that we've got a clear indication of where he may have been assigned. With a music program, it is not uncommon for someone like a music teacher to be working, employed technically out of the central office and going to work at different schools for different periods of time. Including maybe short stints of 5 to 8 days over a summer to do summer programs. So I'm not prepared to give you a complete and full list of all schools yet, but he has been throughout the district over his time of employment.
So his latest, though, his last
2 years, he was a full-time employee working at both Walters and Lawless. And it looks like, I can say at least this at this point, that the majority of schools that he was at, that we have records of him working at, were secondary schools, middle and high school, it looks like, but we'll be able to get a complete record together. I don't want to make a mistake on something like that.
Was he ever involved in overnight trips with the bands? Or?
We haven't even been able to recreate exactly which schools he was assigned to out of the central office over the last 17 years yet. We wouldn't be able to give you that level of detail. And I would also just say that it'll be difficult for us to do that because we've also got a number of principals and others who may have worked with him over the past who have retired and moved out of the area and whatnot. So this will be take us quite a while to figure everything out, but we'll be again providing any and all information that Chief Dyer and his staff need.
Well, Chief Dyer, just one other information, piece of information I need is, you said on July the 31st is when the local shop notified you all.
Yes.
How long, in between that, how long did you do the investigation before you arrested him?
Yeah. The arrest was yesterday. Once we began the investigation, which entailed us reviewing some of the things that were on the computer, arrangements were made on August 4th to actually make the arrest of him. August 7th. August 4th is when we learned that he was a school teacher. So the past week or so has been the ongoing investigation, and the arrest occurred yesterday. And I want to reiterate something I said earlier, is that at this point in time in the investigation, there is no information that indicates that suspect Terry Zane has been involved in any type of sexual activity with children. However, our investigation is early on. What we do know is that Mr. Zane had in his possession on a computer that he owns, that he has said he is responsible for the content thereof, has at least 1,000 images of children that are between the ages of 3 and 17 that are posing in the nude, and that he also has photographs of children that are as young as 5 and 6 years old, the majority of those being female, that are engaged in a sexual act with an adult. And again, that is very disturbing, and it is something that we obviously take very seriously, and we're going to be working with the U.S. Attorney's Office to see if, in fact, this warrants federal prosecution.
No charges have been filed at this point?
The arrest occurred yesterday. He has been booked on 100 counts at this point in time. And then, obviously, the charges actually have not been filed through the DA.
Has he retained legal counsel?
To my knowledge, yes. He during the interview, he did ask for legal counsel.
Do you know who that person?
I do not.
Chief, you may have said this while I was out of the room. You just said that the children who were involved in sexual acts, most of them were girls. What about the nude pictures between 3 and 17? Most girls?
Primarily females on all of the photographs
but there were
that
boys
he conveyed.
As well.
There were also male images as well, children.
And the adult people in the photos, are they men? Mostly men?
Primarily, at this point, there are men involved in the sexual acts. I did view some that had females involved as well, but primarily adult males.
Chief, when he took his computer in, do you know what was the exact reason for him taking it in for work? What was the problem?
I can't get into the details of what that was, but there were some computer problems that he had experienced, and he took it in to have the analysis done and to have it fixed. It's unbeknownst to us why he would do that, knowing that he had all of those photographs on there, other than to say that perhaps he did not think that they would be looked at.
You guys received a call on July 31st from the repair shop?
Yes.
Do you know when or how long the repair shop had actually had the computer?
For just a few hours.
Same day.
Yes. Do you have the name
of
the repair shop?
Yes, we do, but we're not going to be providing that information to the media at this time.
Thank you, Chief.
All righty. Well, thank you. Thank you very much.